Hello world. I am going to do the quick video before I head out for my walk. It is a bit rainy today, definitely gray outside, so I figured I would get this done before I head off on my walk. Wanted to share with you, I do a little bit of reading in the morning. I got a few books that I read, more of the positive mindset sort of books and such like that. So I just wanted to share with you a little bit about the books that I'm reading. I just actually started a new one today. I've actually had it for a while. It's even signed by the author. Had it since 2010 when it got signed by the author. And I've listened to the CD because I own that as well, but I haven't actually read the book. So I'm actually sitting down to start reading the book, this one, this morning. So just a couple of the books that I am currently reading little bit by little bit. I am reading and actually studying the Master Key System, and that is by Charles T. Hanel, I believe is how you say his last name, and that is a definitely older book. It's kind of one of the books that came off from For the Secret and such like that, but it goes along with like what I've read with the Science of the Mind and those sorts of things. And speaking of Science of Mind, by Ernest Holmes, I'm also reading. I've already read through both the Master Key System and this one, Creative Mind and Success. I've already read both of them, but I'm reading through them every morning, reading a little bit every morning just to kind of get that positive mindset flowing and such like that. Book that I picked up at the library that I am reading from time to time. This is kind of getting me some information and help for the money ends of things. It's stuff, of course, on this stuff that I kind of already know and working on implementing on my life on a regular basis. How Rich People Think by Steve Sebold, I believe is how you say his name. And this is actually really quite interesting as well. There's a lot of fun little quotes in here. He basically puts things down real simply, real easily, very similar to some of the other books that I have read, even like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire on that part, but it's just quick, easy chapters and simple, quick reads. But the new one that I started this morning, and I am going to share a little bit with you on this one, is How to Have a Great Day Every Day by Steve Beck. He is also a Montana person. From Montana here, and I have actually gotten to meet him and attend one of his seminar things that he did based on customer service and such like that. But this one, again, I'm just now starting it this morning. I've had it for since 2010 when I got it and he signed it for me. So I've had it for over 13 years. Just over 13 years, and I'm just now actually diving in to actually read it. Because, of course, again, I listen to the CD, but actually sitting down and reading is completely different. And in chapter one, just in starting, I thought this was kind of interesting. He's actually got an exercise that he recommends you practice starting right now and do it every day, several times throughout the day. And I really like this idea. His is to watch your thoughts. I say to watch your thoughts as well as your actions and how you are to people, because this whole idea of this exercise that he's got here can kind of help you understand how you are with the world. Are you blaming other people? Are you being responsible for your actions? Those sorts of things. So even when it comes to your body and healing yourself, are you going to the doctor all the time for this, that, and the other thing? And then is it their fault that you're not healing, or are you willing to take some responsibility for your own body to heal? So that's where I kind of thought of this, and that's just in general, how we are with one thing is how we are with everything. So I thought this was a neat little practice to kind of exercise to kind of practice. It's something that I actually have inquired in my life even before reading this little part of things. And even at the end of the day, sometimes, especially when I was at work and such like that, reflecting back through my day and how did I do something that I could have done better? Was there something that I said that might have been not the nicest thing to say to somebody else? So the way he says on here, it says how it works. Take your consciousness, your awareness, and place it about 2 feet above your head to the right or the left. And this is how to do it. Take your arm, put it straight in the air, and bend your elbow. Point your hand towards your head and pretend that your hand is holding a small video camera. And now you want to imagine that this camera sees every move you are making, every thought you have. And without judgment on any of your actions or thoughts. This is a practice of observing without judgment, or noticing without judgment and just kind of witnessing yourself. So you want to see, you know, pay attention to your thoughts. What are your thoughts regarding pretty much everything? And what are you noticing? Are you noticing patterns of how you are? Patterns of behavior? Are you noticing there are certain things that you choose to do to kind of hide from, whether it be your feelings, the world, or responsibilities? Pretty much everything on there. And he has a list of things that you want to witness while you notice. Look at your thoughts, pretty much regarding everything, other people, your body, focus, laziness, competitiveness, and on and on. And he even states in here, the only way to make changes in your life is to observe how you do things and change the things you think or feel do not support having a great day every day. And it's not just in having a great day every day that these things need to be aware of. It's in everything that you do. So are you having a great day every day? Since 2020, I would say a lot of people would say they aren't. Before 2020, I would say more people thought they were, but since 2020, maybe they are noticing things a little bit differently. I believe that some ways that with all the stuff that happened in 2020, we are now definitely in the time of the right of the survivalists, the right of the fittest, however you might say it. On those sorts of things, the strongest will survive, so to speak, on those sorts of things. But we are coming out of a time where blaming others for actions that you have taken is getting to the end. Making other people responsible for you when you should actually be responsible for yourself, again, those times are coming to the end. I actually read The Four Loves, I think it was, by Lewis, the one that does the Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe. And there was one thing in there that he had mentioned about, and I'm going to kind of go into this a little bit later too, how when it comes to God, we are basically all parasites on God. And at some point, God is going to come to that point of waking up and shaking us all off. So if you are living the life of a parasite right now, where you're in the blaming other people, you're not willing to take responsibility for your actions sort of thing, pretty soon you're going to be shaken off from that part, because we are in those times right now. And so the best thing to do is start taking responsibility for your own body first and foremost, because your body is what you live in. And again, it can heal. You don't have to be reliant on our medical system on a regular basis, because if you are definitely just relying on them, you are most likely on prescription drugs. You are most likely in areas where you possibly have to do surgery and such like that. And again, I'm not saying that you shouldn't go through those things by any means, but they are supposed to be a complementary to health, not the end all everything with health. So that is all I've got today. I'm just going to stay with Steve Beck. Have a great day today. Have fun. Be safe. And remember, your body can heal. So start working on getting into a body that heals. I can help you. See you later.